morning, friends, and welcome back. I am going to show you how I found a vintage window on, I think it was Facebook Marketplace, and it used to look like this, and I turned it into this. You can also find these windows on Craigslist, FreeCycle, as I mentioned, Facebook Marketplace, and sometimes you can find them on the side of the road. So don't forget, guys, I have a book called Successful Decoupage Every Time. It is an ebook. You can download the free Kindle app to your iPad, iPhone, or smart device. That is free. And then you can get all kinds of books for a much lower price. My book is only $4.99. And I wrote the book to help you with all of the questions I have gotten over the years about decoupage, and links that refer you right back to the video so you can see clearly what I'm talking about. So here is how I got this window done. The first thing I wanted to do was I cleaned the whole outside of this with, I think I used a little bit of soapy, bleachy water, just because I don't know where it's been or who's handled it or whatever. This is very important. I am working on the back or the bad side of this window. So when you turn the window over, you'll notice one side is all weathered and beat up. That's really the side you want to be working on because you're going to be placing your images straight up so they are facing out. So just for now, this is the good side that I won't be working on. What I'm doing is I am laying all of my images out, and you can see that I'm just tearing them with my fingers. I'm not using the aqua brush here. I'm just using my fingers and holding my thumbs over the areas that I want to make sure I don't tear. And then I'm just simply tearing out the rest of my images. I'll have links for these napkins down below if they're still available. A lot of times when I put napkins up on my videos, they sell out pretty quickly. But this goes for any image you want to use. You may be using a floral image or something that you really want to make the window out of. So I have not separated the layers yet. This is still three layers thick. And before I glue anything down, I want to make sure that I like the placement of everything first. So all I'm doing, and I suggest you do this too, is just make sure you like the way everything looks, the way it's laid out, and then you can begin to work. And I'm sorry that my camera's not focusing here. I'm just trying to show you that I am removing any hard or straight edges that are on the napkin. Now, when you're happy with the placement of your images, I suggest you take a picture, just a quick snapshot, because there's a lot going on here depending on how many panes you're using, and you may find that you forget how you had it set up. So I'm just taking a quick screenshot, and now I'm ready to decoupage these on here. But what I need to do is flip the window. One other thing I decided to do first, I drew a diagram of the window and just put six panes in here so that I could move my images into this, so that I could just remember, it would be that much easier to move them from this to the window. Now I have to flip the window over. Now this is what I was talking about when I said there's a good side and a bad side. When you flip it over, you can see on the back that this side is pretty beat up. If you'd like, you can take some clear craft glue and just run it along here so that none of this chips away before you get started. And one little trick, when you're separating your napkins, you can take a wet sponge, dampen your fingertips, not too much. You want to kind of pinch your fingers together so that they're just damp, and then pinch the edges of your napkin and they pull away very easily, the layers do. So you can do this to all of your napkin pieces. Now we want to take some napkin decoupage glue. I will have the links down for this below. It is really important that you use a napkin decoupage glue. If you don't, you'll find that your project can become very difficult. You can tear your napkins. This is the Americana decoupage glue. I can usually find the links for it. It does sell out pretty quickly. So what I'm going to do now is start to decoupage, and I'm using my bristle brush. This could be personal preference, but I tend to like the brushes that are on an angle, and you want to make sure you tend to go a little heavier on the decoupage glue. You place your brush down in the center of your image and work your way outward, because this will eliminate the wrinkles. This first bit of decoupage glue that I'm putting down is going to secure the napkin in place. Sorry about that. I realized I had this in the wrong place on the pane of glass. So you place that decoupage glue in the center of your image, and I'll adjust the camera in a moment, and you press the glue outward. Don't forget your image is facing down so that when you flip this over, you'll see the front of the napkin. My camera is having a little trouble focusing. Sorry about that. So what I'm going to do is show you one more time in the center. I'm placing the napkin image face down, and I'm going to put the decoupage glue in the center. That will secure it, and work my way out with the brush. And we don't want to get too much all over the windows. You can wipe away any excess, but I really want to make sure the ends of this napkin are firmly down on this glass. So now I am going to go around all of the rest of the panes and repeat this. I just put a little hole in there, which I'm not too worried about because we're going to do a lot of painting behind this. You can also use that wet sponge or dampen the sponge to just remove any of this excess decoupage glue around your images. You don't have to get too carried away with this, but we just don't want any big gobs of decoupage glue outside of your image. And now that I'm all done with everything, I'm going to let this whole thing dry. I'm actually going to use a blow dryer just for the sake of the video and speed up the drying process. That step has to be dry before moving on to this step. You can use any serious old-fashioned hairspray from the dollar store and sprinkle some glitter on. That hairspray dries clear, it's incredibly tacky, and it will work really well to keep the glitter on these panes. I used a large chunky glitter at first, and then I sprinkled a similar color. I'm using a blue-green theme, and I sprinkled a lighter green color over this as well, and I let it dry. Now, before I move on to the next step, I want to make sure I don't have any loose glitter. So I let this dry, but then I took the blow dryer because I said, you know what, if there's anything loose, and you can see there was a lot of it, maybe I should have pressed it down a little bit. A lot of it did come off, and I'm working on a video about what to do with your spilled glitter, how to reuse it, because I don't like anything going up in the vacuum cleaner, and I actually have a little tool for you to take a look at. You guys know that I love my glitter, and I don't like to waste it or lose it. I don't want to put it in our vacuum cleaner, so I found this cool little bug on Amazon. I think it was about $10. I'll put the link down below for this. But look at this, on a flat surface, it vacuums up this glitter so quickly. And all I do is I empty it out and put it right back into the container carefully, so that I waste very little glitter. So you can see here, I just took a toothbrush, and what I'm doing is I'm splattering some different colors on here. The idea is I'm going for an ocean theme, so I'm splattering some teal paint on here just to add a little bit more depth to my work. And when I'm done splattering all of this paint on here, I'm going to take the blow dryer once again, and I'm going to blow that dry because everything has to be dry before we move on to the next step. You can let this air dry if you've got some time. I'm just trying to get this video done and edited by Thursday, which is why I'm using the blow dryer. Now I'm going to take three separate colors of the Americana Chalky Finish paint. And one of the colors is called Serene, and it's a bluish color. The other one is called Vintage, and it is a soft green color. And then the other one is called Everlasting. And I poured these three colors onto a palette of my own making, and I might have thinned them out a little bit, because here's what we're going to do next. I am taking white craft glue, and I'm going to use a junky old brush, and I'm going to paint the craft glue just in certain spots over my pane of glass. In rushing to try to get the video out, I put the glue over every pane of glass, and you should really only work on one pane of glass at a time, okay? And I'll show you why I'm doing this. I have the paint ready. I have my glue placed down over the surface. Now I took the white and I went over the images because I really want that napkin to pop, and the white helps them to stand out. Once I applied the white, and I'm doing this over the whole window, so every single pane, when I should have done just one at a time, then adding the light green color, and I'm going to leave some open spaces and then add the light blue color to fill in all the rest of these spaces. And make sure you're using a pouncer brush. You don't want to use a paintbrush and smear the craft glue that you'd already put down. Now, to show you what the effect is supposed to be, I'm using a heat gun, and I'll give you a close-up. You can see here some of the crackle effect. And had I taken my time and only worked on one pane at a time, this crackle effect would have been much more visible, would have been much more obvious. It was far too subtle, because now you want to add one last coat of paint over your whole surface. Guess what, guys? I ran out of paint. Can you believe that? I had this one color that I wasn't wild about. It's this blue color, and I put it all over the back because the idea is this is going to show through the crackle. Can you believe I ran out of paint? I'm still dumbfounded. I'm going out tomorrow and I'm buying a whole bunch of supplies. So now what we want to do is just apply a fresh color behind all of the work that you just did, so that through the crackle you will see a very small amount of this color. It all works together when you're using all of the similar colors, and because I'm doing an ocean theme, I just stuck with the blues, the greens, and the whites. This all looked pretty nice, but I'm going to show you now. First of all, I finished all of these panes and then let this dry, and here's how this looked. So as I turn this over, and I'm out in the backyard, I could barely find any sun because I wanted you to see how this glitter looks coming through here. I'll pull back in a minute so you can see the whole window, but you can see how the colors all blended together. I'll be honest with you, I am not fishing for compliments, because I just don't do that. Those of you that have been with me for a while know that's just not my way. I was not wild about this because I had quite a few problems with it. But this is how you do the project. And let me show you one other thing. I practiced this first on a small pane of glass. Here is how this was supposed to look. Sorry about these lighting incidents here. I don't know what's going on with that either. But you can see, to me, this looks a lot prettier. Again, with those strobe lights, I'm sorry about that. Anyway, my friends, don't forget, Upcycle with Decoupage is also on Facebook. If you go over and like and follow the page, Facebook will notify you every week when I put a new video out, or in the event that I cannot put a video up. Wait. So lovely to be with you again, my friends. I hopefully will see you next week with another video. Take it easy, guys. Bye-bye.